below tonight was from Genesis 2 and Proverbs 10. So are you in Proverbs right now?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so I like the second verse in Proverbs.
Treasures of wickedness profit nothing, but righteousness delivereth from death.
I like that because when, you know, I mean, fast money or whatever, like it's pretty good, and it feels good in the moment when you're able to, like, you know, get the stuff back or like buy what you want, like at a quick, without really having to do much. It's a good feeling, but what's not a good feeling is always having to look over your shoulder and making sure that nobody's like catching you. And a lot of times you can enjoy stuff more knowing that you work for it and that nobody's really trying to take you. But I don't know, nowadays everybody's trying to take people's things. So I guess that's a reminder not to be too flashy, because it's always somebody envious of you, will probably kill you over it. And I just, yeah, it's like that because it's a reminder to do your own work. And like, I mean, crime pays, but it also, also pay you a visit to, like, either, you know, whether it might be prison or maybe even the morgue. So that's all. I don't really think there's many criminals who watch any videos, but anything.
You never know. But that's good. And you said it's just better to put your hand with effort to work and then get whatever you need or want. It says, he or she that becometh poor, that dealeth with a slack hand. But the hand of the diligent, when you work hard, yeah. And you might not become a millionaire or whatever, but you will be rich emotionally and mentally and maybe physically. But that's the best type of reward. What you were talking about, the quick money or the quick rewards, temporary, in psychology they call those like the carrots, and those are like extrinsic, you know, factors, and they are not really what satisfies. It's what's internally. So that's really good. The blessings of the Lord, it maketh rich. He's the one who adds and he doesn't subtract. And with the addition of whatever he blesses you, he does not add any sorrow to it, but it's joy and it's peace, so that you can enjoy what he gives you. And you don't have to, like you said, look over your shoulder and deal with that guilt and anguish. So that's beautiful. All right. In Genesis 2, uno dos. Well, the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. That is so beautiful that, you know, we were formed out of nothing and these bodies go right back to nothing. And when you think about just how it disintegrates and it fades away. So while we have the opportunity, we can create something beautiful. And it says that in verse 2, that when God created all that he made, it says, all his work which he had made, and then God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested. So that's what he wants us to experience every day or every night. He wants us to work with our hands, to be diligent, to create, to offer some solutions, to be productive. And then in the evening, we rest from all the work that we were able to manifest during the day. So did you manifest any work today?
Yeah, I woke up early and got some stuff done, but it was mostly just the morning. I kind of should have just kept the momentum going throughout the day. But I'll do better tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah. And we have a chance to do that. And we have a chance to bury ourselves from the day's toil and hopefully wake up early tomorrow with a breath of life And it's only by God's mercy that if he sees fit, he will continue to let us have the oxygen and his very spirit. Amen. And let's just rest from our labors. But know that God wants us to make sure that we stay in communion with him throughout the evening. Look, we were just listening to music, and I said, this is some good music for you to sleep to. You know, I was taking a test, but in the background, it was Handel's Messiah, you know, and you hear that during the holiday season. But it's so peaceful, the overture, the violins, the strings, it's so beautiful, and it's all based on the Word of God. So let's just make sure that we are communing with his Spirit, the Spirit of the living God, and enjoy his presence forevermore. Good night.